It was a gun.
I'm not voting.
If we want to build our nation.
The problem with the Somalians.
Just want to experience something else than a black man.
Move on.
Be like a horse with blinkers.
Honestly say, I was about to have
corrupt
sex and then I pulled
crap,
up.
But it's nice.
I'm Annelien Matiba. I'm a model, actress, presenter, as well as the founder of Proud Albinism.
Hi, my name is Kinele. I'm 36 years old. I'm to a 12-year-old son. And I am an HR recruiter. I'm from Stenberg.
My name is Thembisi Ndane. I'm 37 years old. I stay in Soshanguve, north of Pretoria. I'm a social work student and I work at Childline Gauteng as a social auxiliary worker. And I'm a mother of two.
Okay, guys. My name is Selwane Madia. I'm a music vixen. I'm a debt collector. I'm a financial administrator. And I'm also a mother of two boys. My firstborn is 7. My lastborn is 2 and I'm 30 years.
Tsepang Ntoba. Age 19, was a student at Richfield Graduate Institute of Technology, studying higher certificate in office administration. And I'm currently home now, writing and also doing freelance modeling.
Welcome, ladies. It's so great to have you here within the group. And today the topic is, do you agree that albinism is a disability? And how proud are you of your albinism?
I'm very proud of myself. I'm confident. I love myself. I'm unique. And one thing that I like about myself, I don't let anyone or whatever that comes my way define me. I don't let, as much as I'm different, but I don't let albinism define me to a point that I allow people to just walk all over me because I'm different. Because, you know, we meet different people. Some are judgmental. Some are even scared of us, you see? So I don't let how people look at me define me. I'm me, and there's more to me. And there's absolutely nothing about me without me.
Well, I'm very much proud of my albinism. I don't see myself really different from other human beings. Happy I am. I'm proud to have actually albinism condition because that doesn't define me as an individual or as a person. I'm able to do everything that I do, able to pursue a career. I'm able to be a successful individual. So in with my eyes, look, I don't have to allow that to define me or to meet me in any way, you know, like, as I said, I'm ambitious. I want to be successful. Female living with albinism, and I'm proud to be me.
I'm very proud about my albinism. Firstly, because from both my mother's side and my father's side, I'm the only one with albinism. So that gave me an opportunity to research about it, to know a little bit about it, or more about it, I can say. And then I'm proud because, I went through a lot, from stigmatization, from people spitting into their t-shirts when you come across them, from teachers not wanting to involve you in activities in class, because maybe they feel uncomfortable, from like a lot of things. I can talk the whole day. But one thing that makes me proud of myself is because I have never let any of those things that used to happen to define me. I have never let any of them to make me feel like I'm different or I'm not the same as any other people. I used to take myself as the same as everybody else. From grade 1 to grade 12, I was the only albinism learner at school.
Me too.
So I went to a mainstream school, right? So it was only me from grade 1 to grade 7, grade 7 to grade 8, grade 9, grade 10 to grade 12. I was the only one. So you can understand what I went through three different schools, and I was the only one. So I chose to teach them instead of feeling sorry for myself. Whenever they don't understand something, I will teach them. Whenever they will ask something, I will tell them. Even those that were afraid to have kids like me, they are the ones who made me research more to find out how do one give birth to a child with albinism. So yeah, I liked Loli's statement when she says, what did she say? Nothing about her without her. Nothing about me without me.
Yes.
So I didn't want to let them define me with some things that they are not there. I wanted them to know who am I, and I'm still doing that even now.
I don't have a problem. I'm very proud. At home, they never made me feel like I'm an outcast. I never had confidence problems. To me, it has always been a great advantage because I've always been overconfident, ambitious, and I've always been proud of who I am and the skin that I have. So it was never really a problem. So I am very proud to have albinism.
My type of albinism is ocular albinism, but I think there's type 1, type 2, and type 3. So I think the most albinism that we have is pretty much common, because there's different types of albinism where it only affects the hair or it only affects the eyes.
Yeah.
So I'll ask you, where is your hat? I'm like, I do not wear a hat. Just because I have albinism, I'm not supposed to wear a hat. Why must I wear a hat? I have my sunscreen on, I have my sunglasses or my eyeglasses. I'm doing fine. I'm the one living with albinism, not you. I know how to handle my condition. And not you, because I've been living with albinism all my life. You know what I mean? Do you agree that albinism is a disability?
I do believe that albinism isn't a disability. Ask me why. Our condition is not going to change. It's not temporary. It's permanent. Our eyesight, it deteriorates with age. The more we age, the more our eyesight deteriorates. And then let me speak on behalf of those from the disadvantaged communities. They don't have resources, like the free resources to help, to assist them. Even if they get to go to the hospital, they will get basic spectacles, of which they are only going to help when they're on the sun. But when it comes to reading, when it comes to seeing things properly, well, they're not helping. And then even our skin, if we are unable to take care of our skin properly, like using correct sun protection lotion, like using the head, long-sleeved shirts and long trousers or long dresses, we are exposing our skin to the sun and we are prone to the skin cancer.
Wonderful. I love, like, you put a very long definition to that. And it is very true, because our disability is in our eyesight. And some people feel very strongly about that, and they don't believe that albinism is a disability at all. But hey, we all have our own different choices. We all have our own opinions. So we'll come to Kinelwe. Do you believe that albinism is a disability or not? Do you agree?
Well, it's a no for me, right?
Mm-hmm.
The reason I'm saying no, it's because our skin and our eyes does not have to define us, number one. It does not have to limit us. So, yes, it's a disability, because without the proper sunscreen protection, you are prone to skin cancer and sunburn, right? Without the proper spectacles, you are able to read and write, or some even eyesight are worse to the point where you don't have glasses, you can't do much. But the reason I'm saying no, when you have those, when you have the right resources, you are able to do anything and everything, achieve anything and everything you want.
That's true.
So stick with yes and no.
I believe it's not a disability as such, as Kinelo has said, ne? The only thing that we need attention.
Yeah.
We just need to take care of ourselves. But besides that, I honestly don't see it as a disability.
No, I don't think albinism is a disability. Despite the low pigmentation that we have, despite the bad eyesight that we have, I don't really think I should say it's a disability, because we're just normal like everybody else. The problem has to do with the pigment, the eyesight, and that's basically it.
What would you like to see change for people with albinism in the future or in the present when it comes to workplaces, when it comes to the entertainment industry, when it comes to life in general? What would you like to see?
Firstly, it's for us people with albinism to accept ourselves first. Because for workplaces to start recognizing us and giving us opportunities is for them to see that we are confident enough and we are comfortable enough in our own skins first. Because the first love must start with us. Most of the people with albinism, they close themselves in their houses. Whenever they go to school, they just go to school and come back. When they're looking for work, They must wait for Annalyn to say, hey, where I'm working, they're hiring, then come. You see, like they don't, we're not marketing ourselves. We're not putting ourselves out there to show people that we are more than capable of doing everything that is out there for us to do. Basically, there's nothing that we are unable to do.
If I start accepting myself, I believe other people in the workplace environment, at school, in public, just in community, basically, is to accept me as a person living with albinism. Because people believe these superstitions that they hear about us, these myths, and all these stuff that they say about people who have albinism. Like, most of the time when I'm walking on the streets and I see guys looking at me like I and I'm dressing, I feel like a sex toy or something that that must be used as an experiment. So that is why I'm hoping people learn more about albinism and also learn to accept us in whatever condition that we have.
What I'd like to see with people living with albinism is having more confidence in ourselves, loving ourselves, take care of ourselves, and going out there, advocating as much as we can, and teach our loved ones, families, our communities especially, and also be ambassador to younger girls especially. And yeah, I would think more women and girls that are living with albinism to say you are beautiful just as you are, you know, and you can be anything that you want to be, you can achieve anything that you want to.
My dream is to be in the industry, whether behind the scenes or in front of the camera. I'd really love that. I just love to secure the bag.
My dream is to see every young woman, every girl child that's with albinism, any person they to not limit themselves, to aim high, to believe in themselves, and to build themselves, like rebuild your self-confidence, have self-love.
My dream, as a social work student, when I qualify to be a social worker, I want to help young girls living with albinism to build their confidence, to believe in themselves, to love themselves, and to accept themselves.
My dream is to see Proud Albinism grow, you know, Proud Albinism going up into Africa, because people with albinism up in other African countries, they need us and they're suffering. I've seen the pictures, they don't have sunscreen. And my dream is to get sponsors to fly there and get sponsors for sunscreen, you know, basically Proud Albinism to be a nonprofit organization empire for people with albinism.